All right, guys, so the concept for this week is on negative thinking. What is negative thinking? It's a mindset on how you put thoughts in your brain, okay? You have negative thoughts, things like, I'm not smart enough, I'm not tall enough, I'm not strong enough. If we're talking about martial arts, my belt's not dark enough. I don't have enough experience, I'm not beautiful enough, I'm not handsome enough, I'm not whatever, fill in the blank, whatever it is for you. That's called negative thinking. When you talk to yourself, what are you saying? It's been estimated that 87% of what we say to ourselves is negative. Okay, we call that self-talk. It's, I'm not good enough, I'm not happy, I'm not this, I'm not smart. Guess what? You have to decide internally what's going on. If you take a look at weeds, weeds will grow anywhere. The weeds grow in cracks of sidewalks, they grow in your garden, they will grow on a car if it's left too long and it's got dust on it. Weeds grow everywhere, okay? They don't need any kind of encouragement to grow. But if you wanna grow roses or orchids or any type of an exotic flower, you've gotta have some sort of process in place. You've gotta have the right soil, you gotta have the right sunlight, you gotta have the right watering schedule, or you'll kill it, okay? So our minds are a lot like that garden. Okay, it's not going to spontaneously grow fruit and food for us and vegetables. It won't spontaneously grow that. Spontaneously, it will grow weeds. Our brains are wired for negativity but have to be programmed for success. Okay, if you look at sap on a tree, okay, you look at these pine trees and they have sap on them. And if you go down and cut down a Christmas tree, every year we cut down a Christmas tree, I come home with sap all over my hands, okay? That sap is hard to get off. It's really easy to get on, but it's hard to get off. You gotta scrub at it and use all kinds of different solvents to try and get it off. Negativity is a lot like sap. It's really easy to get onto you, really difficult to get off. And once you get negativity on, you wanna start spreading it to other people. You wanna say, hey, you know what? I wanna share this sap with you. I wanna share this negativity with you, okay? Then you become a carrier. You're like a person with a disease and you're spreading that disease around. Don't spread the disease of negativity. It's too easy to get that stinking thinking and share it with everybody. Don't share that stuff. Find the things to be positive about. Years ago, it was said about people, it was in the book, How to Win Friends and Influence People. He says, when you're dealing with people, don't go into the gold mine looking for the dirt. He says, when you're dealing with people, it's just like a gold mine. You don't mine for dirt, you mine for gold. You gotta look for the gold in everybody. You gotta look for the gold in the situation, okay? Is there gonna be dirt? Absolutely. Are you gonna be covered in it? Absolutely. Are you gonna be filthy? You bet. But look for the positive experiences, okay? So Les Brown, he's one of my favorite motivational speakers. He says, don't be a volunteer victim, okay? There's a big difference between a victim and a victor. Everybody has negative things happen to him, even victors. People that, you look at Michael Jordan, look at how many shots he missed through his career. He's been entrusted the game-winning shot over and over and over and missed it. But they didn't talk about all of his negative achievements, all of the things that he failed at. The reason Michael Jordan is looked at so well is because he kept going and he kept taking that game-winning shot and looking for it. And when he made it, that's why he's remembered, because he made it in insurmountable odds. Okay, Michael Jordan is a great, great example of this. Okay, you have Hannibal is a guy said something really, really interesting. He says, "We will either find a way or make one." Okay, in Psalms 118 verse 24, it says, "This is the day the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it." So you got a day around you. You've got a beautiful, beautiful day. It doesn't matter if it's cloudy. It doesn't matter if it's rainy. Somebody around the world is wishing for the weather that you had. Somebody around the world is wishing for the circumstance you had. Somebody around the world is wishing for the martial arts training you're getting. Somebody around the world is wishing for the education you had, wishing for the parents you had. There is something positive in your life that you can find today. I want you to think about what that is. And use it. Use it as fuel for success. Don't dwell on those negative things. If you've got something negative happen in your life, confront it, deal with it, and move on. Don't think about it all the time. The more you think about that negative stuff, the more it gets on you, the more it spreads to your circle of influence. Okay? You have another thing that happens. You have Art Williams used to say this all the time. He said, nobody wants to do business with a frustrated, dull, disillusioned, sad, daggum crybaby. Okay? Nobody wants to hang out with somebody who's complaining all the time. Okay? It's been estimated that your five closest friends, you take your five closest friends as an adult, you make within 5 to 10% of their annual income. You wanna get better, you wanna make more money? Go hang out with people that make more money. You wanna have better family relationships? Go hang out with people that have better family relationships. You want a better marriage? Go hang out with people that have better marriages. Don't hang out with people who are frustrated. Don't hang out with people that are dull, that are disillusioned, that are always talking negative. Because that negativity gets on you and then it gets in you. Don't be a carrier for that negativity, okay? There's Tony Robbins is another one of my favorite speakers. Tony Robbins talked about the word should, okay? You know, I should get in better shape. I should practice my karate. I should do better in school. I should clean up the house. I should do the laundry. I should cook a meal for my children. I should, I should, I should, I should, I should. Tony Robbins said, you are shoulding all over yourself. Stop shoulding and start doing, okay? The last thing I'm gonna leave you with, you wanna get out of your negativity, you gotta do some things for motivation every day. You gotta put out some aspirations, some goals. Find out what you want. Stop focusing on what you don't want. If you focus on what you don't want, you're gonna keep getting it. The definition of insanity is if you do the same thing over and over and over and over and expect different results. Find out all the things that you don't like. You can write those things down, but then you need to write a statement, a vision, a philosophy, an affirmation, if you want to call it that. Write out its opposite. If you're sick of being broke, write out its opposite. You know what? I'm going to be wealthy, okay? I'm going to have enough money to do this, 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 and this. I am free to travel because I have enough money to travel, okay? If you're sick of being overweight, you say, you know what? I hit the gym often enough and I eat clean enough that I weigh this amount and I feel great in my body. And write down those things, okay? You gotta have some goals, okay? Then you gotta take action. Tony Robbins calls it, you gotta have a map, okay? You know, you have like that map that when you're traveling, now we use GPS, but there's a map inside that too. You gotta have a map. You gotta call it a massive action plan. It's a map. And what you wanna do is you have to create a plan to take some massive action, okay? So I want you to go out and figure out what your map is, okay? If you need to lose weight, you need to figure out how to start eating cleaner, start exercising better, okay? And start trimming down your portions, okay? There's a guy named Ian Abernathy, love the guy. He is a martial arts high-level master, and he talked about, you know, he took some before and after pictures. You know, he's got his belly sticking out in one, and then he's got a ripped six-pack in the other. And he talks about a lot of those are faked. He says he took those pictures like 12 minutes apart, and one of them he looks ripped and the other one he looks fat. Okay, it's the way he held his body. Okay, but he talks about this, and yes, he had gained some weight, and then he started working it off. He talked about how he worked it off. He said, I ate less. Yeah, I got out and I worked out, but the bottom line is I ate less. I had less calories in my body to work with. Okay, so if you want to do that, you got to put some specific goals in place and then take massive action. You got to have a massive action plan. Don't sit around and stay frustrated. Whatever you're frustrated about, write it down. You can even burn it. Write it down. You can write down a whole page of why you're frustrated and what you're feeling. Take it outside and burn it. And then take its opposite action. If you're frustrated about something, take its opposite action. Go out and win today. All right, guys, have a great week.